From Timaru to the world stage, the fabulous actor, performer, creator, cabaret and disco king, Mika joins us now with his brand new biography, I Have Loved Me a Man. Never has it been such an appropriate title, I reckon. It is so great to have you on the show, back on the show.
Yes.
Welcome along. Now, I was flicking through your book before and I have to
and
be
spitting your tea across the room.
Really careful about which pages I open up to on morning television, but I did see this particular one which I thought...
Jim Moriarty.
Now that... That is an 80s haircut if ever I've seen one.
80s, that's definitely 80s with a sort of Issey Miyake sort of jacket on.
That is beautiful, and I cannot flick through anything else because I might accidentally get a bit of a... it's a great, fantastic book. How excited are you to see Life in Print?
Very. It's a release. Like, now it's out, I can let lots of stuff go. The Auckland Museum has now just collected heaps of Mika archives into Papa, and time for the new thing to happen.
Brilliant.
But I've kind of released everything in the book.
There's
certainly everything. For those who don't know what everything is, there are some nudes. But they are tasteful and art. In a period when we used to have more nudity on stage, but now it's all online, no one cares. But people will still be, as I said, spitting their tea across the lounge.
No, you're right, it's very arty,
Yes. I've got a few aunties down south in Timaru going, not quite more in them.
We can't show this to the coffee group.
Is it nerve-wracking, Mika, putting out a book like this? Because you have really bared everything, so to speak, but not only just the photos, but your soul, and it affects other people as well. So do you get nervous?
No, I don't get nervous. I think the purpose of a lot of the stuff I do now is about the change I do within my own charitable foundation, that like the mental health work, the suicide prevention work we've been doing for years, and I think if I expose myself, which is a good way of putting it, it allows other people, because I'm pretty out there. I mean, there's no doubt about it. I know my thing.
Yes, you are, Mika. Yes, you are.
But sometimes it allows people who are a little bit to go a little bit, because I've gone so far. I've noticed that a lot.
If you go that far, they can go that little bit nearer and not feel so self-conscious about everything.
I mean, see, when we were, food for thought before, when you were talking, what they're doing, everyone talking, mental health is right across the board. There's no prejudice, it's everywhere. So I know this book already, talking to this, some young people and stuff already speaking to, go, oh, we didn't know. Like, see, once upon a time, I was a gay Māori male. Now I could be gender-bending, fluidy, I can like women now. Couldn't back in the old days. A long story, we'll talk about that later. But, you had to like girls or boys. Now you can, it's a more freer society, but it's harder too, because now people don't know where they are.
Well, and, going back to those early days in Timaru, I mean, you were adopted by two Pākehās. Mm-hmm. You were very active sports-wise in school. Did you know you were gay?
Well, the word homosexual was about 12 syllables, so I couldn't say it when I was 12, but I definitely knew by year 9 or third form, and I was out at an all-boys school, Timaru Boys High School. I gave a speech on gay law reform in year 9 to all the boys in Timaru Boys High School.
And how did that go down? Because that's pretty much, that's a pretty ahead of its time.
I was fine. Well, I was a rugby player, and I was the fastest track and field kid and the disco king.
Wow.
So I think if I'd been the ballerina violinist, potentially. I've always said this, it would have been a different world, Also, boys back then didn't know what a homo was, as they said. Mm. They didn't really know. I didn't, not like today.
Yeah.
And some of them thought, I must just can't be real, And I was also like the only Māori in the school as well. So, one of these things is not like the other.
So what gave you, though, the courage to be comfortable and do those speeches at school? And, also what did I find out? That you wore a silver skin tight dungaree catsuit with high heel boots to the Timaru Boys Mufti Day. What gave you the courage to do all that? Because most people would hide that.
Yeah. I don't know.
Was it your parents?
Was it supreme self-confidence or...?
It was just the ability that I knew who I was. Mm. Okay. I knew that very early on. Like, I was in one of those kids who would get a bus ticket and go for a bus trip on his own for an adventure and come back.
Yeah.
Might have only been to Mooka, 12 miles down the road, but
still,
it was a big trip. I was just one of those children.
You felt good about who you were too.
Yeah. And sort of and I could sing and I could dance and I had all those other things, so theatrical maybe.
Well, what haven't you been? I'm a hairdresser, Les Mills instructor in complete lycra, a disco champion.
World Aerobic Championships, yes.
Cabarets, a dance party, you've done so many things.
Yeah. I'm so glad.
Been in some great movies, yes, gone around the world, met some incredible people.
TV, yes. Post the nudes in a book.
Post the nudes of the book, yes. No one's going to post the nudes of the book, but I tell them, but you'll have a Pinterest, won't they, one day? Gay Māori man, Mika, be everywhere. Be like, all over Pinterest.
No, that's it, you've done everything. What is next?
That's right.
What are you going to do next?
I'm making a film next.
Oh.
Yes, I'm making a film on a very famous Māori drag queen.
Oh, Carmen.
Yes, that we start in February.
Nice.
And then after that, I don't know. Life is this wonderful thing where I've been able to grow and change and still remain in the industry on my own terms.
Yeah.
But my foundation work, mikahaka.com, if anyone's, that's the thing I kind of keeps me going.
That's, that's your love.
Because you get a bit bored of your own, you know, like, I mean, I'm doing media and I love media. It's what you have to do, but it's what we do.
Yeah.
It's the joy I get is seeing, like, Ryan Turner did his first show at New Zealand Fashion Week this year, and I took five of them to Edinburgh Fringe a few months ago.
Nice.
And seeing them, it's like, for me, you know, it's like,
give something back a little bit. What do your friends and family think of the book?
My family love it.
Yeah.
Although they want free copies, but I've said, no, go to every good bookstore in New Zealand and get it, you know. No, my sisters and brother, they're fantastic.
Yeah.
But they knew years ago when I was, just a little thing that you had to kind of accept me as I am or lose me, really.
And who wrote the foreword? Because that's pretty impressive.
Sharon Mazer wrote the book, of course, some New York academic, wonderful woman, and Witi'i Maida, my very good girlfriend of many, many years.
That is a great
look at that picture at the back of a gay dance party. I'm the only person who Witi would let put in a book. So, yeah, very respectable, Witi'i Maida. But it's that gay cachet, I think, you know, because it's like, you know, the Mika effect. Oh, yeah, I can be a gay around Mika. It's kind of okay.
Well, you put that in the book, finally. Yes. Is there anything you left out of the book?
There's lots of things I left out. Oh, my, look, we're out of time.
Oh,
I'm sorry. Oh, sorry about that. We're out of time.
Volume 2.
Volume 2. Yeah, there you go.
I have loved Mere Man. The Life and Times of Mika is available now from all great bookshops.